No great quantities of semen need to be used to generate and reproduce offspring. All that is needed is for one or two of those eggs to find their way into the woman's generative system and to produce offspring. And there are ways of learning how to not ejaculate and at the same time produce offspring by only allowing a small portion of that semen to leave the body. And you can learn this through Tantra. There's many ways of learning this, but one has to do the research. It's a whole other show, so I can't really go into it. But the draining of this seed is harmful on all levels. So what used to be taught in the ancient mystery schools was a great portion of their enlightenment was to learn how to practice sex. Hence you'll see temples all over India which have what we call, in our ignorance, pornographic scenes. So you'll have all these carved stones of men and women in all kinds of sexual, nude, tantric positions, because they were temples where you would go for that specialization, to learn how to have the spiritual orgasm. So rather than discharging the energy through and the life force down the bottom, a man would learn how to engage properly in non-lustful sex and generate a spiritual energy in the body with their partner and have what's known to be a spiritual orgasm or an air orgasm, because obviously the material one is water. Remember, the elements are earth at the bottom, then water, then air, then fire. So if you're having the water orgasm, that means you're going to be discharging fluids, which are very crucial for the body to be built up and to be to build up its spiritual intelligence. This is why you see a lot of zombies out there, because they are actually emptying their brains out when they ejaculate. So these beautiful souls need to be taught how to stop this and save that and transmute it. And so what they will learn in Tantra is how to go beyond the physical orgasm in their mind. So they have to learn certain breathing practices and certain holding muscles in a certain way so that there's no discharge of fluids. And what happens then is they rise above that physical level of pleasure and they go into what's called transcendental pleasure, and where you can sustain an orgasm for 10 hours if you want, and you do not lose crucial life force and life energy.